you can have on your life and your business.
Don't be too succeedy.
Okay, sorry.
So, the battle for Christmas number one is raging. The might of the X Factor winner Joe McElderry is up against the online campaign by fans to get the US rap metal group Rage Against the Machine to the top spot. I downloaded it myself the other day. It was kind of liberating feeling.
I prefer swing, don't you?
Sheila, I love a bit of swing.
I love a bit of swing, don't we?
We haven't got time for that particular plug.
We always have time for that.
Let's speak now to the band. Good morning. How are you doing?
We're doing well. How are you?
Oh, good. Is that Tom there, yeah? Sorry?
We're all four of us are on the line right now.
Oh, fantastic. You could be number one for Christmas. How would that be, and what would you like to say to the potential buyers listening?
Oh, hi. This is Zach De La Rocha speaking. How are you? I think it'd be kind of a wonderful statement. The kids in all over the UK have responded to this incredible internet campaign. And I think that it says something about, you know, the real tensions that people are experiencing all over the UK and the United States as well. And I think people are just would love to hear a song that reflects some of the tensions that they're experiencing in their daily lives, and we're very excited about it.
Do you think it's a rage against the manufactured pop business?
Well, I mean, this has been a real, completely grassroots campaign started by real fans of music, and I think it's tapped into the silent majority of the people in the UK are tired of being spoon-fed one schmaltzy ballad after another, and they want to take back their own charts. And we are honored that they've chosen our song to be the rebel anthem to try to topple the X Factor monopoly.
What about those guys who say it's on the same record label as Simon Cowell, so ultimately he will still benefit? He operates under the Sony umbrella.
Yeah, well, first of all, people are not buying Killing the Name to protest a record coming out on a company. We wrote Killing the Name in a small industrial slum in Los Angeles. The X Factor song was written by a cabal of overpaid songwriters to shove that schmaltzy business down your throats. So it's they're two very different choices. And the thing is that listeners need to know is it's a really close race. And I think that it's a real liberating musical revolution that people are on. And again, we're really just honored to be a part of it. One of the things that we're doing is joining all the people from the Facebook campaign to help with an organization called Shelter, which is a homeless charity.
Yeah.
So some of our proceeds, the windfall of proceeds from this is going to be going to Shelter, and you can learn about that at shelter.org.uk.
Brilliant. And what do you guys think of Simon Cowell?
Simon is an interesting character who seems to have profited greatly off humiliating people on live television. And has a unique position of someone who could not only, capture the attention of some people on television, but also in the airwaves. So we see this as a necessary break in the chain of that control.
Quick word from, stay there, guys. You're going to play for us in a second. Say, John Mortar's on the line now. He launched the Facebook group to get you guys at number one in the chart for Christmas, Rage Against the Machine. John, what would you quickly like to say to Rage Against the Machine?
Hello, guys. I'd just like to say it's an honour to be on the same show as the guys, and it's great to hear you.
Well, we'd like to thank you very much for what you've done. And I think it's an excellent lesson for people that whether it's in a small matter, like who's at the top of the charts, or bigger matters like war and peace and economic inequality, when people band together and make their voices heard, they can completely overturn the system as it is. We would now like to play a song for you.
Let's get Christmassy.
Merry Christmas.
Here we go, people.
The band warming up to play.
We
can
just fill in the
Rock!
Told you. Now you do what they told you. Now you do what they told you.
Now you do what they told you.
Now you're under control.
Now you do what they told you.
Now you're under control.
Now you do what they told you.
Now you're under control.
Now you do what they told you.
Now you're under control.
Now you do what they told you.
Now you're under control.
Now you do what they told you.
Now you're under control.
Now you do what they told you.
Now you're under control. Don't let die or justify. Wearing the badge and your chosen white, you're justified. Don't you die, but wearing the badge and your chosen white, don't you die, justified. Wearing the badge and your chosen white, don't you die, justified. Wearing the badge and your chosen white, come on.
Sorry, we needed to get rid of that because that suddenly turned into something we were not... we were expecting it and asked them not to do it and they did it anyway. So by Joe's records, it's 3 minutes... it's 3 minutes past nine.
On digital and online.
This is BBC Radio 5 Live.
Good morning. It's the breakfast phone-in on 5 Live and I was so engaged in listening to that piece of music that I need to very quickly get this up. But we're talking this morning about drink. And we're